unbelievable, you know, to see the support, the fans, all my Irish jerseys and everything coming out to support as well. It's absolutely amazing. And, you know, this place is Shane, and I'm here to coach Shane as well on May 7th.
May 7th, you're taking on Jane De La Rosa, a very tough fighter. We saw what he did to El Perro Angulo in his last fight. Are you ready for this fight? With 10 professional fights taking on a Jane De La Rosa. Jane Quigley, you've been knocking everyone out in front of you. Are you ready to knock out Jane De La Rosa?
100%. You know, I've trained my ass off in the gym. I've worked my way to get to this position. And I'm going to grab it with both hands. I'm going to Shane. I'm going to put on a master class on May 7th.
Let me tell you something, Jay. I'm a fan of boxing. I'm a fan of Jay Quigley. Ladies and gentlemen, Las Vegas, give it up for the undefeated, Jason Quigley. Watch this man, Diego De La Hoya. And I'm going to start off right off the top. Diego, welcome to Las Vegas. Your first time in Las Vegas on a card like this, Diego.
I'm very excited to be here, to see all the beautiful people, all the Mexican people here supporting, and I'm ready to fight.
Diego, what do you have to prove in this sport, especially on a week like Cinco de Mayo, on an undercard to Canelo Khan, and having a name behind you like De La Hoya? Is there pressure on yourself right now, Diego?
Adicional por el apellido de La Hoya peleando en una cartelera de este nivel, Canelo y Khan, ¿y qué tienes que comprobarte?
Bueno, yo soy de La Hoya, 100% mexicano, de Mexicali, y la verdad me siento muy contento que me dan la oportunidad de Golden Gate Promotion, y la verdad mi apellido es una gran presión, pero le he sabido manejar.
No, I'm very excited to be on this card. I want to thank Golden Boy Promotions for the opportunity. Yes, there's a little bit added pressure, but I've known all my life how to handle it, and I'll do it on Saturday night as well.
You're fighting a very tough Rocco Santamora. Good luck to you, Diego De La Hoya, undefeated. You've been shining. You've been doing a great, great job. Your punches are just so accurate. Get ready, ladies and gentlemen, for Diego De La Hoya! Unas palabras, some last words for the fans here, Diego.
Bueno, que mi pelea va a ser una pelea muy dura, pero guardo todo de mí como todo mexicano y voy a salir con la victoria.
I know my fight's going to be very tough. I'm fighting an undefeated opponent, but like a well-trained and schooled Mexican, I'm going to give it all in the ring and I'm going to come out with the victory. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Curtis. Welcome to Las Vegas. Welcome back to Las Vegas. Are you ready to take on an undefeated Patrick Nick Sierra this Saturday, May 7th?
Of course, hard training camp,
his O has to go, and we know that you're a beast in the ring when it comes to your knockout power. Do you plan on going the distance, or you want to take him out early and give his first O, not just an O, but a knockout?
Of course, we can test him early, but the knockout comes to come and not be looked for.
Now, there's a word that you could be heading to for another world championship title shot if you get past Nick Sierra. How do you feel about that?
I'm excited, man. This is my dream boy, my life. So when I get to him, next step, world champion.
Curtis, is there pressure? I mean, the guy's not Mexican, but you're fighting on a May 7th, you know, Cinco de Mayo week, where there's a lot of Latino fans. Does there pressure come behind that, or does it motivate you more to go in there and do your job better than how you do it already?
Motivation, get there and just work and get the crowd excited to fight.
Let me get your real take, man. Both fighters are both good. I got respect for both of them. We want to know the real truth for you. Who do you got, Canelo or Khan, this Saturday, May 7th?
Yes, sir.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen, from Brooklyn, New York. Give it up for Curtis Stevens! Are you ready to be on such a mega undercard to a big HBO pay-per-view like Canelo Khan?
I'm Japan. I'm very happy to be here, and I'm ready to show my work to everyone.
Yo, let me tell you this, Patrick. To my right is your opponent, Curtis Stevens. He's known for his knockout power. He's in great shape. He has a great camp. And I'm gonna call this out in front of all these fans. He said he's planning to knock you out Saturday night. What would you like to say in response to Curtis Stevens planning your first loss by knockout?
Good luck.
He says good luck, ladies and gentlemen. What do you think about undefeated Patrick Teixeira? Good luck, Patrick. Este sábado, unas palabras para toda la gente aquí. Some words for all the people right now, Patrick.
Que eu espero fazer uma grande peleia e mostrar meu trabalho para todos, especialmente para os mexicanos.
I look to do great work and show my work to everyone, especially my Mexican friends.
Who wants to see these guys face off right now? Make some noise, MGA! Undefeated, taking on the always exciting Mauricio Herrera. I'll start with Frankie, right with that question. You are fighting the always exciting Mauricio Herrera. You've seen this guy fight, you've been next to him, you've been at his fights. Are you ready for this fight? Now that we're here, Frankie.
Mauricio Herrera is a great fighter, but with a lot of experience, but so am I.
You know what, Frankie? I don't want to go backwards. In career, that's not how I like to do things, but there's a lot of fans and there's a lot of media and people seeing that Frankie has had opportunities and chances and here we are again against a fighter like Mauricio Herrera who always comes to fight, has controversial losses, feels that hasn't gotten his way, and here you come undefeated from East LA, ready to make your mark in boxing. What do you have to say to these people that have these up and down feelings about you from your career, from media to people?
I'm just gonna show them May 7th, and I'm not going there to lose.
Your training camp has been insane. I've been seeing you on your IG with Freddie Roach. Talk to us about your training camp. How different was your camp than other camps? And you look great, Frankie. You look absolutely amazing.
Thank you. Training camp, I've been getting ready for this fight for about 12 weeks. And just 100% focused on sport, and I'm ready to go.
Is there anything that you are worried about with Mauricio Herrera? Is there anything that you see in Mauricio that you may have to watch out and say to yourself, you know what, let me be careful on this right here?
Yeah, he's very crafty and with a lot of experience, fought a lot of great people, but I think I'm ready.
After this victory, Frankie, where do you want to go in your career? Where do you see yourself in boxing?
Well, I'm going to look past this guy, but if everything goes good, I'd like to try to show.
Ladies and gentlemen, May 7th, HBO pay-per-view. He is from East LA. He is undefeated. He is a pit bull! Mauricio, we know that you've had a career where things have been taken from you, decisions not gone your way. What are you going to do this Saturday so that does not happen again?
Well, me and Frankie Gomez are going to create something very special Saturday night. We're going to steal that show, so make sure you get your tickets, because they ain't going to take this one from me.
Frankie's been training with Freddie Roach. He's undefeated. Mauricio, you've been working really hard in boxing in this sport. How has your training camp been for this fight to prepare for an undefeated Frankie Gomez? And let me ask you this also, Mauricio, do you feel that you're coming in here as the teacher to teach a lesson to a younger student like Frankie Gomez?
Yes, you know, training camp has been tough, a long camp.
like every camp, and that's the toughest part is in camp, and it's only to make it an easy night for Saturday. Maestro will show up. I'm not burned out. I'm hungry to win, and we're going to see. It's going to create something special, like I said. Frankie Gomez is undefeated, and if I must slay another dragon, I must do it again.
What do you see in Frankie? Is there anything in Frankie that in your training or watching tapes or videos or anything, or just being at some of his fights that you see, you know, I've got a fight on my hands. This is something I need to be careful for. It's something I got to watch out for. What can you say special about Frankie or a flaw in him that you see why you're going to win this fight?
Well, Frankie is a tough, he's undefeated. He has everything going for him. And I think he wants a spot. He wants my spot. He wants to take everything that I have built and struggled for to this point. And so we got to make sure that doesn't happen. But I respect him as a fighter. He's a tough guy. But it's my extra time. This kind of time will come later.
I'll be honest with you, man. I feel this fight takes the show. East LA versus Riverside. And Maestro versus the Pitbull. Ladies and gentlemen, Golden Boy Promotion. Make some noise right now. For Maestro Mauricio Herrera. Very sure of yourself. You're fighting a former world champion, David Lemieux. How confident are you for this Saturday, man?
Without a doubt, man. I feel good. I train really hard, so, and I don't have to lose all this weight, so I feel so good. And I couldn't be better.
What can you say about David Lemieux, his style, you know, something about Lemieux that maybe you have to look out for or worry about or maybe nothing at all?
He's a tough fighter. He comes in to fight. You know, I respect him. I respect what he does. You know, so I can't really talk bad about him. He has a better resume than me, you know, so I'm just going to show people what I can bring to the table.
Now, you're the co-main event. I have to ask this, man. You're the co-main event to a Canelo Khan in your weight division. How do you see this? You win, you beat David Lemieux Saturday night. What do you see for your future? Possible Khan, possible Canelo? Is this something that you want for yourself near, coming soon?
All I'm thinking about is David Lemieux. There's nothing else in the future, you know, if I don't beat David Lemieux. So at the end of the day, it's just David Lemieux on my mind.
All right, I like that. I like that answer. Let me ask you this, a real honest answer here, Glenn. Who do you have Saturday night? Saul Canelo Alvarez or Amir King Khan? None of that. I respect both fighters and they're both great. Who do you see winning? Why? How? Let us know, man. Your prediction of the fight.
I can't say Khan with all the Mexican people in here, man. So I gotta say Canelo.
You're right. Canelo Alvarez, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up. Our co-main event live on HBO pay-per-view. The always exciting, the very talented, the ready to go, El Chingon Glenn Tapia!
I guess someone like Canelo, who's gonna come to fight, and you know, I'm gonna be more than ready. So I've done everything I've been asked to do, and I've had a great training camp. I got Virgil Hunter here, who's been pushing me very hard. Also Luis Garcia, my other trainer from a conditioning. I'm conditioned, I'm ready, and I can't wait for Saturday. I can't wait to beat the titles back home in England.
Here. We've been able to get to watch your beautiful family on HBO 24/7. We've been able to see your physical training, getting prepared for Canelo Alvarez. But as a fan myself of boxing, as a fan of such big events like this, I like to know personally, and I'm sure a lot of fight fans would like to know, how do you mentally get ready for something so mega? HBO pay-per-view, Chico de Mayo week against a Mexican star like Canelo Alvarez, with all these Mexican fans on Chico de Mayo week, mentally, how do you get yourself ready for that?
I mean, mentally, the way I get myself ready, you know, I do my prayers and everything. I've got a great family around me. You know, my family helped me. I've got great British fans here who have traveled all the way from England. We've got a Khan's army here. Where's the Khan's army at? I mean, the lovely thing about it, I did say, even though it's Cinco de Mayo and it's a Mexican holiday, we're going to see a lot of British flags, and I can see so many already. So I just want to say thank you to all you guys for the support. But this is a big, big fight. I mean, Canelo's a star in Mexico, in America, and I'm fighting as the underdog here. But I've come as an underdog to win this fight. You know, I'm not coming by anything else, and I want to take the titles back at home, back in England.
Amir, my last question. What? After you get this win against Canelo Alvarez, where would you rate this in your professional career, rank it as accomplishments in your professional boxing career?
You know, a win over Canelo would be probably one of the biggest wins of my career. Obviously, like we said, Canelo is a superstar, and being on Cinco de Mayo, you know, I think it's a great place to beat someone like Canelo in front of all the big boxing fans. And I really believe I can do that. You know, that's why I took this fight, because I really believe I've got the strength, I've got the power, I've got the speed. I mean, this is going to be an amazing fight. You've got two young fighters, you know, who are hungry to be the best. So I just want to say a big thank you again for you guys. Also, the Mexican fans, look, I'm not forgetting about you. We are Mexico. The Brits are always behind me, and I just want to say a big thank you guys. And I'm not gonna make you upset. You're all gonna be very happy come Saturday night. I'm gonna be the new middleweight world champion, guys.
Well, one last question, Amir. I gotta ask this for all the fans. Do you think you can really knock out Saul Canelo Alvarez Saturday night?
So looking for that Canelo, I mean, I think it'll be difficult to knock Canelo out. But I know one thing: I would give him a boxing lesson.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Bolton, England.
Representar a mi país en estas fechas tan importantes, lo hago con mucho orgullo Y no hay mucho que decir, ¿no? Esperemos el sábado 7 de mayo para salir con otra victoria. Gracias.
There's not a lot to say. I just want to thank you all for the support. We've worked hard. I'm very honored to be working and fighting on these days and representing my country, Mexico. And we're going to celebrate on Saturday night. Thank you very much.
One more question. Canelo, do you want to knock out Amir Khan? Do you plan on knocking out Amir Khan? Or are you trying to go this distant fight with him?
You're
the best. You're the best.
He said he trained hard for 12 rounds. He's looking forward. He's ready for 12. If the knockout presents itself, of course, I'm going to take it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only, El Orgullo de Guadalajara.